In the next line to it, a very important link between academics and industry is shared infrastructure. Now, what sort of shared infrastructure I am talking about? The last few years have not been easy for Indian universities. They have had to deal simultaneously with policy uncertainty, technological innovations, new things happening, Baijus coming into picture, people like Baijus and Topper coming up with a new way of delivery, greater competition as a result of internationalization and globalization, industries, academic institutions are emerging as industries. There are global regions which are acting as hub of higher education and research, foreign universities attracting Indian students. So, again the number is declining at our end. Rising expectations from students and of course, new pressures to tighten budget and get the greatest return from their scarce resources. Similar changes are being faced by industry also. So, in fact, academics is becoming as an industry with proliferation of private institutions and universities. Education also is being talked about like an industry. So, if there is a recession in industry or if I talk about some crunches in education industry, such crunches exist in normal industry also. So, now we are talking about a situation when similar challenges are being faced by both academics and industry. How do we do it? Save money. These financial pressures have led to further exploration of where the academic center sectors can work together with industry to respond to their financial challenges. Collaborations between universities or colleges, academic institutions and industry can be put in place to share infrastructure like data centers. Industry, they need data centers, education institutions, they have the research wings, they have their own data centers like MIT database that is being used across the world for doing research on early detection of cancers and likewise. So, ultimately big education institutions, they have their own data centers, let industry use them. Libraries, we have wonderful libraries, laboratories, business incubators. Let there be a business incubator which can be established within the industry, but it would be used by the students. Knowledge park. I am establishing a knowledge park within a university. So, industry establishing a knowledge park within academic institution. Skill labs. Skill labs for training the human resource of industry. So, I can have that lab established in my academic institution or some of my labs can be multitasked for acting as skill labs. So, opportunities are endless. It is all up to the right people to decide upon the right sort of association. So, this is what I meant by shared infrastructure, which can be beneficial for both academic institutions as well as industry. I have talked about certain collaborations or certain methods of collaboration like data centers, libraries, laboratories, business incubators, knowledge parks, skill labs. These are something which as a teacher you can think of and plan with your local industry. Since we are talking about research and we are talking about industry interest into new findings and all that, one of the strengths of academic institutions is their intellectual property. And what is the need of the day is commercialization of intellectual properties. Academic startups, they need to develop an intellectual property strategy in order to commercialize and monetize the new inventions. Once an IP asset has been created, a new activity comes into picture, that is IP management, which needs to be taken up, which involves creating economic benefits through portfolio management, integration of IP into business strategy and maximizing the value of IP. Why to go for only theoretical research? If this theoretical research can be put to practical use, it would be a huge resource for both academics or academicians as well as for the industry. A fundamental consideration of any IP strategy is to always balance any short-term gain against any potential long-term pain with regard to the company's business goals. Be very clear about it. In the short run, it might sound very lucrative, but in the long run, it might be difficult to sustain this sort of an association relationship. A common strategy for commercialization is to sign an exclusive licensing agreement to the company's core patent in order to secure a royalty stream, as simple as that. But it needs to be clearly understood that a licensee who does not prioritize promoting and exploiting the licensed IP could become a liability, because academicians are academicians. We do not have the business acumen. This is all we can say. But if you are forging a business alliance, you need to talk about the basic deliverables. This could in turn prevent the company from moving forward with other more productive partnerships. Hence, proper legal formulation of the association is always advised. An alternative solution might be a licensing agreement that clearly accounts for the above situation. So, this was about commercialization of IP. In fact, from the industry perspective, what I was talking about was the academic perspective. But if I talk from the industry perspective, the IP management strategies should ensure few things, like they should limit prosecution to innovation that can be most cost effective and developed rapidly internally. So, do not run to the academic institutions directly, introspect, can it be done internally. Acquire those assets that are most efficiently deployed by others. So, if you believe that developing solution X involves n number of resources, and if any academic institution can develop the same product X with n minus number of resources, outsource it to them. Next, sell or otherwise eliminate IP not relevant to current management strategies, reallocate these resources and rebalance the portfolio. In a zeal to compile up the IPs, make sure that you do not get stuck up with legacy products which are not going to be fruitful in terms of commercial implementation. Using the basic portfolio management strategies mentioned above, academic research should focus on the innovation and research that is central to the company's core business goals. Next, the academic researchers should understand what other technologies complement their offerings and look to form partnerships in order to create higher value solutions. And lastly, they should ensure that their resources are directed towards the core IP that supports the business goals. What I mean here is that the objectives should be synced with each other. There should not be deviation into the common objective. If that occurs, partnership will never be successful. The IP strategy should be tailored to support those goals by maximizing the legal protections available and minimizing risk and liability. This will lead to long-term sustainable relationships between the academics and the industry. Commercialization of IPs, many ethically think, is not correct, because eventually what we are doing is adding to the body of the worldly knowledge. But if that knowledge can be converted into a commercial product and then give leverage to society, why not? So, let us not discuss the moral and ethical issues of it, rather we should talk about the implementation part of it. The last link, but the most strong link, is with respect to scientific publications and informal interactions. Why is it important? Because this significant link is through sharing of scientific publications through informal interactions. You will agree with me that interpersonal relationships define the bonding strength of any association. Deriving mutual pleasure and satisfaction from an association supersedes all other materialistic benefits. So, what we advise is association be established by sharing scientific knowledge with industry through social ties using conferences, meetings, social networks, get-togethers. Simply meet, discuss and bond. That is the rule of thumb. So, these are the basic links which can be established, which can be forged between academic institutions and industry. There could be instances wherein a link can be implemented, or all of the links can be implemented or some of the links can be implemented. Based on that, we will say that we have low level of interface or high level of interface or high level of association. All said and done, there are few things which are very important. Monitoring. If I have implemented an association and if it is not going to be monitored properly, there are high probabilities that it will deviate. The basic law says any system left to itself will move towards disorder. So, if you have forged an association, you cannot leave it unattended. It has to be constantly monitored and nurtured. Having discussed the model, I come to a very important activity associated with the model, and that is deriving the indicators for monitoring. Every link and its associated activities need to be monitored to ensure the effectiveness and proper functioning of each of the links. Monitoring can be done. How do we do this monitoring? The obvious question arises. This monitoring can be done through a set of indicators for each of the links. Now, I am going to discuss some of them, like it might sound a bit confusing that what indicators I am talking about or what sort of monitoring I am talking about. So, let us talk about the first aspect of it, that was curriculum and course design. So, now we have forged an alliance, we have a partnership. Now, how do I test, how do I monitor whether this association is being fruitful or not? So, there are certain parameters for that. For example, number of industry oriented courses. So, through this association, I have started 3 industry oriented courses which are required to train a huge workforce which is the need of the industry. So, the association or the link has done its part. Option for multiple entry and exit points. So, what we have done is we have defined a course, or we have come across a scheme where a student can enroll at any point and leave at any point, and every stage they are getting some diploma or certificate. So, if we have given such sort of a thought process, that means that proper input has come from both industry as well as academicians. Think of a course, like I am getting admission directly into second year BTech, I leave my course after 1 year and I say give me a degree. As an academician, you laugh at him. But industry will say he has devoted 1 year of his efforts into this course, why don't you give him a diploma? These are the inputs. If such things are coming in, then we can always visualize that we have had proper input from industry. Composition of the curriculum design team. Look at the efficacy of this association. If there are 5 academicians involved and only a single individual from the industry and 3 courses have been designed, what we have done is an eyewash. We have not obtained proper input from the industry, because a single person is not expected to be trained in all these expertise. So, a casual look at the composition of a curriculum design team itself will tell you that how much sincerity has been given to this association. Heterogeneity of the team. Have we addressed all our strength areas? Who are the members who are participating into it? Is it a one-one mutual understanding, or is it the 2 teams working together or 2 organizations working together? Heterogeneity of the team will tell you that. Another simple indicator could be number of such meetings. If I believe that we have formed a course or we have designed a curriculum in a single meeting, needless to say, the efforts are casual. So, these small measures, these are the indicators which will help to tell you that whether a particular link has been seriously taken up or not. In fact, there is no fixed checklist for it. Depending upon the association, these will vary. Another important link was human resource training and transfer. Now, how do I monitor it? Again, a very simple indicator like number of trainings. We have forged an association, in past 6 months we have not organized even a single training, either for the industry practitioners or academicians or students even. That means it has become a formality, we are not delivering. Number of technologies covered. If there has been a training, what have they discussed? Is it a single domain or have they covered multiple aspects of it? So, Human resource training can be monitored from multiple aspects. How many trainers were involved? How many individuals have benefited? How many students have benefited? If a teacher has taken a training, how many classes that teacher has taken, or how many training sessions that specific teacher has conducted? If a student actually took that training, what was the response in the placement, or did they get any placement offers? These are simple numeric entities, numbers. So they act as wonderful indicators to decide upon the sincerity with which that specific link has been nurtured. Similarly, we can talk about academic entrepreneurship. If I am talking about entrepreneurship, the worst and the simplest measure would be number of patents. Have we produced any patents? Have we created any technology which has been accepted by the industry? Or has there been any product developed by the company? Number of products developed by the company X with input received from faculty of institution Y. These numbers will simply tell you that what has been the impact level of this type of association. Similarly, if I talk about research partnerships and research services, they are very clear objectives. How many projects we have undertaken? How many industries we have partnered with? What have been the successful number of implications? These are small numeric values that will give you deep insight into the level to which the link has been taken. And do this. This exercise has to be taken care of. Shared infrastructure. We say that, okay, we have an incubation lab. How many people have actually utilized it? We are saying we have given a research laboratory or a laboratory for industry. What has been the footfall? What has been the lab utilization? What has been the space utilization? How many walk-ins have been into the library? How much time has been spent by these people into the library? Are they actually using it? Again, these are the indicators which will tell you whether the shared infrastructure is properly utilized or not. If I talk about commercialization of IP, number of patents converted into commercial products. Okay, as an academician, I have developed 10 patents. Are they being used commercially? If yes, the number itself tells that whether my research or this association is becoming fruitful or not. Scientific publications. Again, if you are talking about an association wherein your scientific publications are being used, what has been the number of publications and what has been the impact factor? What was the nature of publication? What was the type of the journal? Was it any round-the-mill product, or is it some usually fruitful journal or something? Again, these are numbers. Informal interactions. We say that we are going to talk about our common interest. Did you ever meet? If you met, who were the participants, or how many were the participants? These are the numbers which we need to look upon. So, what I have tried to explain here is a set of measures which will actually tell you whether the partnership is being properly handled, taken care of and nurtured or not. Without this type of monitoring, again, industry academia interface will become a fad. It will become just a poster for the academic institutions that we are in tie up with this industry, and industry will take it as their CSR. That should not happen. That is not the objective behind describing this model. So, please be very clear about these pitfalls, that in haste to go into this sort of association, we end up into more of a formality sort of a thing rather than an actual working model. Now, having talked about all these things, what would be the implication of this sort of association? The biggest challenge which the Indian education system is facing today is lack of employment, unemployability of, or rather we are acting as factories for generating unemployed graduates. That will not happen. You will have a proper research direction. So, academic institutions will directly contribute into nation building because they will address the areas which are the need of the day. We won't have to reinvent the wheel. The things which are already being practiced or researched by academicians, industry working on the same, or industry having their team working on the same, not required. Don't reinvent the wheel. Increase number of placements. As a direct benefit of this association is that your teacher will act as a placement officer. Your teacher, what he is teaching in the class, that will directly reflect into the placement of the pupil. What can be a better blessing to a student than this? Creation of new products and services. Because if you are getting feedback from the industry, you are actually developing something which has a commercial value, and this gives you acumen to develop new products and services. Remember the example of Ola and Uber I talked about. Emergence of new business models with enhanced opportunities. With understanding of the functioning of the businesses, academicians, teachers would be able to imbibe the sense of business acumen into the students. Competitive edge over other industries, because if you have a manpower who are constantly innovating for you, who are constantly thinking of deriving new products for you, who are constantly improving their products, who are constantly talking about increasing the efficiency of your functioning, definitely you are going to get a competitive edge over your competitors. Employability was a direct outcome of this thing. One indirect outcome is industry modernization, because if an industry is getting constant inputs from young innovators, young people who are graduating, who have a zeal to innovate, who have a zeal to make a difference in this world, they are definitely going to bring a lot of modernization into the industry, lot of change into the industry, lot of change into the society, and lot of change in the national building. So this is a sort of industry academia interface which I can think of, or which I believe would be a blessing for the Indian education system. Thank you very much.